Well, proceed to the second item. Okay, the second item is that we have been granted city status for Penang Island. Finally, so Penang will be a city status after such long time. I'll pass on the other details to YB Chow Kon Yap. So these are the information that we can review at this stage. Cabinet has finally approved, and Penang will finally be known as a Penang City Council. Penang Island City Council. Ask YB Chow to give you the details.
Baru-baru ini, pihak Kerajaan Negeri telah terima surat bertarikh 10 Disember dari Kementerian Kesejahteraan Bandar, Perumahan dan Kerajaan Tempatan, that is the Ministry of Urban Well-being, Housing and Local Government, yang memaklumkan bahawa Jemaah Menteri telah setuju dengan cadangan untuk menaik taraf MPPP kepada status bandaraya pada mesyuarat kabinet 7 hari bulan November baru-baru ini. Itu sahajalah yang kita boleh maklumkan sebab perkara-perkara lain perlu menunggu pengumuman rasmi setelah berkenan oleh Yang Dipertuan Agong Malaysia. Jadi kita cuma pada peringkat ini dibenarkan memaklumkan bahawa setelah menunggu sejak tahun 2010, permohonan pihak kerajaan negeri untuk naik taraf status Majlis Perbandaran Pulau Pinang kepada Majlis Bandaraya Pulau Pinang telah pun disetujui. Itu pengumuman yang kita nak buat. Lain-lain butiran akan diumumkan apabila matang. Itu saja.
How you mentioned before about the allocations and all that with the city status, but generally how else can Pinang benefit to those city status?
Together with the application, the government, federal government requires us to also furnish them with a list of additional posts that would be required or that could be approved once the municipal council attains city status and they have approved the additional posting that the MBPP would require. That is approved together with this application. So in one sense, we will get additional officer, staff and all that. And that would be approved together with this application for city status. And I didn't want to complicate matter. There's another approval together with this application. That is to revise the boundary of administration of the new city council, which includes all the reclaimed area created in recent years, which include McCallum Street Guard, which include the whole IJM foreshore reclamation, and also the Tanjung Pinang area, reclaimed area. All this has been included, or the boundary of the municipal or the city council now includes all this reclaimed area, and that has also been approved. That means any applications for development would now come to the city council instead of the town and country planning department. So I didn't want to complicate matter. So together with this approval is also an approval to enlarge the boundary of the council. We will give details when everything is finalized. It's in the region of a few hundreds, few hundreds.
But principally, already approved by the ministry.
But whether they send the officer is, whenever the needs arises and there is an officer to be sent, then they will send. or whenever there's vacancy to be filled, the council will fill it.
You wait for the details. Yeah. You wait for the details. You just make an announcement that Penang Island has united city status. Any other questions?
But when will this status come into force?
Or is it? That is a part that we cannot announce because the consent has to be made by the Yang Di Pertuan Agong.
So if you announce it was actually approved by Cabinet in November.
Yeah, that part we can announce.
Okay, any other questions?
Thank you.